Australia-China tensions have continued to rise, with Beijing taking aim at Australia's economy by targeting our biggest trade industries. But how's that really turning out? Australian beef sales to China are down 50% compared to last year. If you don't hear beef producers complaining too much, that's because beef prices are high. Despite a big customer drop-off, they can still fetch excellent prices on their meat. Winemakers have more to be upset about, with wine sales to China down 96%. But the industry is showing resilience and helping to make up for it by exporting more to the UK, US, and Canada. Aussie wine sales to Hong Kong and South Korea went up 55% and 72% respectively over the last year. Iron ore is the most crucial aspect of our trade relationship with China. This is sold in huge volumes and at the moment commands a record high price. China's well on their way to diversifying their supply away from our iron ore, but currently, despite tensions, it can't. Australia sold $19 billion in iron ore and related products in the month of May 2021 alone, and much of it went to China. That $19 billion flows into the Aussie economy and helps support our jobs and our incomes. For now, despite the threats, China's reliance on iron ore is still propping up the Aussie economy on the whole.